Good afternoon. Today we are going to discuss on the osteoarthritis. It is very common disease which you will be finding day by day in your OPD. So what is the definition? So osteoarthritis is nothing but a degenerative non-inflammatory joint disease characterized by destruction of articular cartilage and the formation of new bone at the joint surface or the margin. It's called as osteoarthritis. So it is osteoarthritis will be forming by two word, osteo and arthritis. Arthritis concept is very separately, means there will be, you can find a mono and one side leg also, you can find in different types of arthritis we have mentioned. The types will be a primary osteoarthritis and secondary osteoarthritis you will be finding. So in primary osteoarthritis, it will be there in a two form, maybe a localized or it may be a generalized form. And in secondary osteoarthritis, we'll be finding secondary to a previous pathology. Means in primary osteoarthritis will be very common in nature, and in secondary osteoarthritis we'll be finding some other disorder along with osteoarthritis changes. So the etiology, primary osteoarthritis mostly seen in a old age and a weight bearing joint, those person whose weight will be very heavy. So primary type of osteoarthritis will be finding in both of them. Predisposing factor, like in a female, most we will be finding in a female. Obese patient, heredity and genetics, age and old age. Age related, mostly in a old age, occupational stress and strain will be the key feature. Then endocrine disorder, if there will be a estrogen will be a decrease, and metabolic disease like diabetes mellitus, in some of the cases you will be finding a associate component like osteoarthritis. So in secondary osteoarthritis, the causes like trauma, there will be some malignancy, inadequate blood supply to the particular part, infection of the joint, nutrition, bone disorder if person will be having, inflammatory diseases, some other disease like obesity, gout, RA and diabetes. So this is belongs to a primary and secondary. So primary only a weight bearing joint, and there will be some other causes like diabetes mellitus if person is having, and weight bearing joint and obesity. This will be the main feature. And in secondary, there will be some trauma, some malignant condition, some infection, some nutrition, other disorder will be there, and along with that, there will be it may lead to a secondary osteoarthritis. So what do you mean by osteoarthritis? So osteoarthritis is most common form of arthritis and the most common joint disease. The most of the people who have OA are older than, it will be more than 45 years old, and women are more commonly affected than men. So OA is the most common, occurs at the end of the fingers, thumbs, neck, lower back, knees and hips, as it is mentioned in here, neck region, lower back region, hip region and both the knees. So main what it happens, so actually the repair mechanism of the tissue absorption and the synthesis get out of the balance, and it result in the formation of the osteophytes formation or the spores, you can see here. So this is a natural one, and you can find here bone spores will be there, so it become a osteophyte changes will be there, okay. So you can see this is the normal one, this is the normal one, and this is a exposed bone, this you can find here, okay. This is a exposed bone, and this is a bone spore, or you can see, or you can called as a osteophyte. So basically, osteoarthritis is a disease of joint that affects all of the weight bearing component of the joint. It like articular cartilage, meniscus, and bone. So osteoarthritis based on the articular cartilage. The articular cartilage is the main tissue affected. As a result, it may increase tissue swelling. There will be changes in the color. Cartilage fibrillation will be there. Fibrillation is nothing but a, let's say, RE hoti hai apni. आपने देखा होगा आरी, ठीक है। सो सिमिलर वे द बोनी स्ट्रक्चर विल बी देयर फिब्रिलेशन टाइप, ओके, एंड कार्टिलेज इरोजन डाउन टू सबगॉन्डल बोन। सो दिस इज यू कैन सी नॉर्मल आर्टिकुलर कार्टिलेज एंड सेकेंड पिक्चर ऑफ बी देयर विल बी ऑस्टियोआर्थराइटिक कार्टिलेज। सो हियर यू कैन सी द जूम, जो जूम होता है, जूम करके देखते हैं ना अपन, सो इट इज अ 3000x जूम इन दैट नॉर्मल आर्टिकुलर कार्टिलेज विल बी लाइक दिस। एंड इन ऑस्टियोआर्थराइटिक कार्टिलेज यू कैन यू फाइंड विद द जूम ऑफ 3000x, सो यू कैन सी द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ इट, द कार्टिलेज स्ट्रक्चर, ओके। सो यू कैन सी हियर दिस इज अ जॉइंट कैप्सूल, दिस इज अ बोन एंड दिस इज अ सिनोवियल फ्लूइड। The synovial fluids leaks into the cracks which can form in the bone surface when this replacement cartilage wear away. This causes further damage, in some cases can lead to a cyst-like structure. Okay, so there will be a formation of cyst-like structure due to a synovial fluid because it goes to a it leakage will be there in a that cracks. Okay, so this is belongs to a normal and osteoarthritic changes. So in normal bone or a normal knee joint, you can find a capsule joint. There will be a synovial fluid will be there. There will be a articular cartilage will be there. You can see here articular cartilage. And this is a joint cavity will be there. And this is a bone. Okay. So in osteoarthritis, you can find that some control bone cyst formation will be there. The capsule joint will be thickened. And which the synovium membrane which will be there, so there will be inflammation of the synovitis membrane. You can see here, this is the inflammation will be there, and there will be a early degenerative articular cartilage. You can see here the structure. After that, you can find this like structure in osteoarthritis, and as I said, fibrillation. You can see here fibrillation like. आरी आरी की तरह का फिब्रिलेशन हो जाता है इसका, ठीक है। तो कॉमनली अफेक्ट्स द जॉइंट इज हिप्स, नीज, फीट, स्पाइंस एंड हैंड्स। अनकॉमनली अफेक्टेड जॉइंट्स लाइक शोल्डर, रिस्ट, एल्बो एंड एंकल जॉइंट। सो ओवे यू कैन फाइंड दिस टू नोड्स इन सम ऑफ द नोडल ऑस्टियोआर्थराइटिस। यू कैन सी हियर नोडल ऑस्टियोआर्थराइटिस। So this is nodal osteoarthritis. It is a bony enlargement of the distal and proximal interpharyngeal joint. It is also called as a Heber-Dunn's nodes and Richards nodes. Can identify this both the nodes in the nodal osteoarthritis. So risk factor, the age, of course, age. It maybe starts in a young age and mostly you can find after 45 years are the more risk in nature. Female, of course, the females are more prominent to have osteoarthritis. It may be due to a joint alignment also. So there will be a joint will be incorrectly placed. Some person is having bow legs. So due to that, there will be a formation of osteoarthritis. Some hereditary gene defect, if it is there, so due to that there will be a cartilage deterioration of the cartilage will be there, and due to some very most common is joint injury or overuse of that particular or physical activity if you are doing a sports, due to that also there will be some traumatic injury will be there, and particular to that ligament or meniscal tears, it is a very common in nature, so you can find. And in that person, you will be finding a OA. So, in of course, obesity due to a overweight during the midlife. So, due to that, there will be a person will be finding a OA in a knee joint. So, pathology. In pathology, there will be a pressure area. So, pressure area mostly in a particularly knee joint, very common. And there will be a increased water content in a joint, water content in a joint, and depletion of the proteoglycans. So proteoglycans is nothing but a It is a compound consisting of a protein bonded to a mucopolysaccharide group. It is specially present in a connective tissue. So this proteoglobulins is present in a connective tissue. So the depletion will be there, and it may lead to a fibrillation. As I said previously, fibrillation will be there, and which form the subchondral bone exposure, and there will be a hardening of the bony tissue will be there, and formation of OA. And in if it may be there in non-pressure area, so there will be a bone hypertrophy, which may lead to a osteophyte changes, and there will be a loose flakes will be there, and they will be inflamed of synovial membrane, and further they will be fibrosed capsule, and some synovial connective tissue will be there. They will be fibrosed, and they may lead to a osteoarthritis. So clinical features mostly in old age, sex more in females, site mostly in weight bearing joints. So symptoms like pain, stiffness, deformity, swelling, and limping. This will be the feature. Then tenderness in some of the patient will be finding. Crepitus is the common one. Enlargement of the joints, deformity, effusion, and terminal limitation of the joint movement. Means the range of movement will be restricted. So risk factor, it cannot change, like family history of disease, increasing the age, and being female. And the most of the female patient, you will be finding osteoarthritis, very common in nature. Okay. Risk factor, you can change. Overuse of the joint, of course you can do. Major injury, overweight, you can reduce the weight also. And muscle weakness, if you are having a muscle weakness, you can strengthen the muscle. If you are having a overweight, you can reduce the weight. And if you are using more of the joint, you can little bit go to do a little bit work. Okay, so diagnostic criteria for osteoarthritis, it is a medical history, physical exam, x-ray, and other test. So in OA symptom, mostly 1/3 of the people whose x-ray shows osteoarthritis report pain and other symptoms, and there will be a intermittent pain will be there in the joint. Stiffness will be there, mostly it will be seen in sleep or sitting time. Swelling or tenderness is one and more joint will be there, and crunching feeling or sound like crepitus will be there while moving. This is the common features. So there will be a major two types will be there, OA, as I said, primary or idiopathic, and secondary. Okay, so in primary, this is the most common type diagnosed where there is no any cause for a symptom. Secondary, diagnosed when there is a identifiable causes, like there will be a trauma or other underlying joint disorder if it is there. So in OA, in grade they have defined. So stage 1 grade, there will be a clinical symptom minimum will be there. X-ray and appearance will be nil or minimal changes will be there. In stage 2, there will be a mild. And in X-ray appearance, there will be a decreased joint space will be there. Stage 3, it is a moderate clinical symptom will be found out. And in X-ray appearance, there will be a osteophyte formation will be there. And in stage 4, you can see here, stage 4, so you will be finding severe condition, and malalignment will be seen. Malalignment means the alignment which will be there, so it will be tilted. So laboratory finding, so in laboratory finding, you have to do a ESR, CBC, and RA titer. It is to rule out some other arthritis. And in synovial fluid, you can find a leukocytosis. So you can do with the synovial fluid analysis. Severe and acute joint pain, so uncommon manifestation of the OA. WBC you can find, and the normal viscosity you can see. So differential diagnosis, of course, it will be directly correlate directly you can differentiate with the rheumatoid arthritis. Of course, there will be a gout. So in gout, you can find swollen joints will be there. Okay, and one more CPPD. So this is a calcium pyrophosphate crystal deposition disease. Anybody know about this? Roll number 8. Roll number 8.
Yes, sir.
माहिती आहे का काही सीपीपीडी बद्दल? कधी ऐकलंय?
नाही सर.
फुल फॉर्म तर मी लिहूनच गेलाय. सीपीपीडी मीन्स कॅल्शियम पायरोफॉस्फेट. ऍक्च्युली काय होतं याच्यामध्ये की कॅल्शियम पायरोफॉस्फेट विल बी अ फॉर्म ऑफ आर्थरायटिस दॅट कॉजेस पेन, स्टिफनेस, टेंडरनेस हे सगळे प्रोड्यूस करतो इन मोस्ट ऑफ द जॉईंट्स. ठीक आहे, युजली याच्यामध्ये काय होतं की मोस्ट ऑफ द जॉईंट्स मध्ये कॅल्शियम डिपॉझिशन तयार होऊन जातो. ठीक आहे, ड्यू टू दॅट देअर विल बी स्वेलिंग राहते त्याच्यामध्ये, स्टिफनेस राहणार, पेन राहणार, आणि तुम्हाला नियर बाय सिमटम कसे असणार, तुम्हाला सिमटम दिसेल रुमेटॉइड आर्थरायटिसचे. तर तुम्हाला आयडेंटिफिकेशनसाठी त्याचं कॅल्शियम लेवल टेस्ट करावं लागेल. तर एक लक्षात ठेवा की कधी पण तुमच्याकडे आर्थरायटिसचा पेशंट आला तर कॅल्शियमचं थोडंसं इन्व्हेस्टिगेशन तुम्हाला करावं लागेल. ठीक आहे, नेक्स्ट इज सेप्टिक जॉईंट. ऑफकोर्स काही सेप्टिकमुळे त्याला लिजन तयार झाले असेल तर त्याला सेप्टिक ऑस्टिओआर्थरायटिस डिफरेंशियल डायग्नोसिस मध्ये येतो. आणि एक आहे पॉलीमायल्जिया रुमेटिका. कधी नाव ऐकलंय याचं? नाव ऐकलंय कधी पॉलीमायल्जिया रुमेटिका? इज अ इन्फ्लेमेटरी डिसऑर्डर. याच्यामध्ये काय असतो की मोस्टली अ मसल पेन विल बी देअर, मोस्टली मसल पेन अँड स्टिफनेस. दिस इज द मोस्ट कॉमन सिमटम असतात. आणि त्याला स्पेशली शोल्डर आणि हिप्स मध्ये खूप दुखते. आयडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ द लिजन हे पण तुम्ही आयडेंटिफाय करू शकता की त्याला फक्त शोल्डर आणि हिप्स मध्ये असेल आणि मसल मस्क्युलर पेन असेल आणि स्टिफनेस असेल तर तुम्ही एक अंदाजा लावू शकता की दिस मे बी अ पॉलीमायल्जिया रुमेटिका. दिस इज यू कॅन फाइंड इन अ रेडिओग्राफिक डायग्नोसिस. This is a normal one. This is normal one. And you can find a space between that will be reduced, and this is cyst and bony structure will be asymmetrical joint space narrowing and loss of articular cartilage. So you can find mainly in a radiographic diagnosis asymmetrical joint space narrowing. So you can find here narrowing will be there. Periarticular sclerosis, you can see here periarticular sclerosis. Osteophytic changes, you can see here osteophytic changes. And some subchondral bone cyst. So this is will be a subchondral bone cyst. So you can find in osteoarthritis basically a four classic findings on X-ray. So subchondral cyst you can find here. Then in sclerosis here. Narrowing of the joint here and osteophytic changes will be in spore, bony spores will be there. So treatment principles. So in treatment principles, mostly delay in the occurrence to stop the progress of the disease and rehabilitate karna hai apko patient ko. Theek hai. So pain medication, mostly non-operative treatment mein pain medication apko dena hai, physical therapy dena hai, walking aids karna hai, shock absorption karna hai. ये एलिमेंट थ्रू ऑर्थोटिक्स. ऑर्थोटिक्स इज नथिंग बट शूज आते हैं ऑर्थोटिक्स, तो वो पहनने के लिए देना पड़ता है पेशेंट को. एंड लिमिट स्ट्रेन टू अफेक्ट द एरियाज अदर एरियाज. एंड द सपोर्टिव थेरेपी देर विल बी वेट रिडक्शन, रिड्यूस्ड एक्टिविटी, सपोर्ट एंड प्रेसेस यू कैन गिव. फिजियोथेरेपी यू कैन गिव एनएसएआईडी ड्रग्स, इंट्रा आर्टिकुलर इंजेक्शन and some local application you can give to the person. Surgical treatment indication, persistence, if person will be having persistent pain, repeated acute episode of the locking, there will be a deformity, joint inability, progressive limitation means the range of movement will be very reduced. So in this condition, you have to go with a surgical treatment. So this will be a surgical treatments, excision of the osteophytes, excision कर सकते हैं इसका, joint debridement कर सकते हैं, excision of the loose bodies जो भी होंगे उसको remove कर सकते हैं, distal femoral osteotomy कर सकते हैं, orthodesis कर सकते हैं, ठीक है, then patellectomy कर सकते हैं and high tibial osteotomy कर सकते हैं. This will be a surgery can perform. Contraindication, so in inflammatory arthritis, if you find a tricompartmental osteoarthritis and flexion arc of the 90% or less. So in most of this condition, if you find a secondary condition like tricompartmental, means there will be some other secondary causes if it is there. So in this condition, and flexion arc will be 90% or less, in this that condition you can can't do a surgery, and in inflammatory condition you can't do a surgery. Okay, this is related with the osteoarthritis. Any doubt?